Hello friends, welcome to Trending Telecast. In this video we are going to see some social news, so let's start the video.
First news is about coronavirus update. The number of coronavirus cases in the country crossed the 52,000 mark on Thursday with 52,952 total cases. According to the latest figures updated by the Ministry of Health, there are 35,902 active coronavirus cases in the country, 15,266 patients have been cured or discharged while 1,783 people have died from the deadly contagion across the country. Next news, Vizag gas leak live updates. 8 people, including 2 children, have died while about 300 are hospitalized after a gas leakage from LG Polymers chemical plant in RR Venkatapuram village, Visakhapatnam. In Andhra Pradesh today, the Vizag factory was trying to open post-lockdown when the incident occurred. Several people were taken to hospital after they complained of a burning sensation in their eyes and breathing difficulties. Next news from West Bengal Hospital. A 400-bed multi-speciality hospital in West Bengal's Kolkata decided to shut down its operations, barring a few, on Monday evening, saying a number of doctors, nurses, staff members and attendants have contracted the coronavirus disease, COVID-19. The Peerless Hospital is among the big private institutions where COVID-19 patients were being treated. A senior doctor at Peerless Hospital in South Kolkata, who did not want to be named, said more than 10 people have been affected and at least 3 among them are doctors. Next news is about online shopping data. 40 days of pent-up demand for non-essentials released on Monday brought back some e-commerce action on the first day of the relaxed lockdown guidelines, following the Ministry of Home Affairs directive that allowed e-commerce companies including Amazon, Snapdeal, Flipkart, others to resume services of non-essential goods in green and orange zones. The marketplaces reported thousands of sellers receiving orders for such goods. The majority of orders received belonged to apparel, electronics, home and household product categories. After that, all liquor shops in Mumbai will remain closed from Wednesday as the Mumbai Municipal Corporation has decided to let only essential services function in the city. On Tuesday, Mumbai Municipal Commissioner Praveen Pardeshi issued an order saying that only groceries, medical, chemist shops will be allowed to be opened. The development comes in the back of huge crowds thronging the liquor shops in Mumbai and the police machinery simply unable to control the crowds. Next news come from Hyderabad. Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao on Tuesday announced extension of the lockdown in Telangana state till May 29, irrespective of the nationwide lockdown announced by the centre till May 17. The situation in the state capital, Hyderabad, and its neighbouring districts, Rangareddy and Malkajgiri Medchal district, is very serious and there is no way we can take any chances, the Chief Minister said, after a marathon cabinet meeting at Pragati Bhavan here. Next news come from Kashmir. Riyaz Naiku, the top Hizbul Mujahideen terrorist who had never been caught, has been gunned down by security forces in a joint operation in his South Kashmir's village on Wednesday. Naiku had come to meet his family on Tuesday and stayed overnight at a hideout in Avantipuras Bebara village. This was home turf. The 32-year-old, also known by his alias Zubair-ul-Islam and Bin Qasim, was counted among Kashmir's most experienced terrorists. On 5 June, Riyaz Naiku would have completed 8 years in the Hizbul Mujahideen, a rarity in a career where many don't last for more than a few years. Security forces had come close to cornering him on several occasions. He managed to dodge them every time. After that, the Delhi police on Wednesday arrested an 18-year-old boy who was the administrator of the group Boys Locker Room. Toy on Wednesday was the first to report about the boy being picked up from Noida. However, the documents to establish his age were being verified. Investigating officials revealed that the accused boy had recently appeared for his class 12 board examination and was awaiting the results. During interrogation, he told the police that he had created the group but did not know everyone on the group personally and had added them through mutual references. Next news, Mumbai is on the verge of an unprecedented public health emergency crisis as both public and private hospitals in the city are swamped with huge numbers of COVID-19 patients, even as ICU care facilities of almost all hospitals are getting exhausted and a shortage of nearly 400 doctors and healthcare professionals is turning the situation alarmingly grim. Despite lockdown, Mumbai is witnessing 400 cases daily on average. The city's medical infrastructure is finding it difficult to meet their needs, forcing a few to wait on roads overnight before the administration makes arrangements. 2 health. The Kolkata traffic policeman on duty amid the coronavirus COVID-19 lockdown. A doctor has designed a new face mask to ease the problems of the cops in the sweltering heat. The new mask resembles the face shield similar to that in a personal protective equipments PPEs, but unlike the coverall, which has to be worn from the feet causing sweating, this mask covers the head and bust. There arises no necessity to wear another protective gear over this. Next news. The Union Home Ministry on Wednesday expressed dismay over the grave lockdown violations in West Bengal and observed that people playing cricket and football shows poor supervision by the district authorities in Kolkata and Howrah. The ministry's comments were based on feedback presented to them by the inter-ministerial central teams, which were deputed to Kolkata and Jalpaiguri districts since April 20 and returned on Monday. While pointing out that testing carried out in the state in proportion to the state's population, Union Home Secretary Ajay Bulla said that mortality rate at 13.2% in Bengal was the highest in the country for any state. After that, some municipal corporations in the Mumbai metropolitan region have barred their residents from returning home if they work in Mumbai, triggering a sharp response from employees in essential services. MMR has 9 municipal corporations, including Mumbai, Thane, Ulhasnagar and Kalyan Dombivli, with an estimated population of 23 million. The municipal bodies of Kalyan Dombivli, Ulhasnagar and Badlapur issued orders on Tuesday banning their residents to come back home if they travel to Mumbai for work. Next news. In a stern warning to West Bengal on Wednesday, the centre asked the state chief secretary to ensure that lockdown measures were strictly implemented as its 2 teams had found specific groups in specific localities of Kolkata and Howrah violating lockdown. Next news come from Indo-Bangladesh border. The centre has slammed the West Bengal government for not allowing the movement of goods carriers through Indo-Bangladesh border, which, it said, is an act of violation of the constitution and will have international implications. In a strong worded letter to West Bengal Chief Secretary Rajiv Sinha, Union Home Secretary Ajay Bulla directed the state government to allow transportation of essential goods through borders without any further delay. Next news. A powerful earthquake shook islands in eastern Indonesia on Wednesday evening, but no damage or injuries were expected. The quake measured a preliminary magnitude 6.8 and was centered below the sea at a depth of 107 kilometers, 67 miles, the U.S. Geological Survey said. It was located 205 kilometers, 128 miles, northwest of the nearest city, Somlaki, it said. The earthquake triggered moderate shaking and was unlikely to cause injuries or economic losses, USGS said. Thank you for watching this video. For more news like social news, tech news, business news, science news and sports news, do subscribe our channel and stay tuned with us to get such trending news every day. If you like this video, click on the thumbs up button below and share this video with your friends and families.